We're waiting for the A-10s to fly over. What do you guys know about this plane?
Well, it's it was built and entered into service in 1977, and it's designed around the big Gal 8 Gatling gun. If you've never seen this gun, it's very impressive. 50-millimeter rounds is what this thing shoots.
Wow.
And so they pretty much took this huge cannon and designed the airplane around it. As the folks at home can see the A-10 data screen there. Superior ability at low speeds, absolutely true. Max speed around 439 miles an hour. Might be a little on the fast end there. Primarily meant to get low and help the Army guys on the ground.
Well, yeah, they call them the Warthog, and they're tank killers, and that's what they're meant to be, but it's one of my favorites. Paul, I used to love to see these. When you go down to Myrtle Beach, you'd see them taking off there all the time, and boy, without these, we'd be in trouble. They're usually our first line of defense.
I think if you talk to anybody that's in the Army in the front lines doing the battle out there, they love the A-10. That is their friend up in the sky because they can get called in and deliver ordnance with pinpoint accuracy right on the front lines and keep them safe. And the enemy really hates the A-10. 30-millimeter cannon shoots 3,900 rounds per minute. Depleted uranium bullets, which are armor-piercing, wow, can go through anything. If you ever watch it, see some of the demo tapes of that thing, that's just like a fireworks display with the impacts of all the bullets hitting that. And then the airplane itself, designed around the cockpit, is a titanium tub, which protects the pilot from any kind of 23-millimeter or up to 57-millimeter bullet. So it gives them a little bit of a comfort, but it also increases the weight of the airplane. But it's a trade-off. But it's just capable of going out and taking a hammering by enemy forces. You know, it's been beat up. They've been shot at. It's able to fly with one of its wings gone, one of the tails gone, one of the engines out. And the airplane is still battle-hardened to be able to recover and come back in.
Here they come. They're going to converge on us right now, and they're going to simulate an attack on the 2nd Street Bridge. We're going to get a good look in a minute from our cockpit cam.
I don't know if you can see it, but they also sometimes paint a simulated canopy on the bottom of the airplane.
There we go. Firing on the Clark Memorial Bridge. Well, it looks like the bridge is firing back. I don't blame them.
The airplane flies slow and tight turns down in close air support. It can maintain good contact with the troops. The pilots are able to maintain good visibility with that bubble canopy, and they can deliver their ordnance on any kind of target in the close proximity to friendly troops without injuring our troops and taking out the enemy positions.
It seems like this would be a heavy, hard plane to fly. Am I right or wrong?
Well, you know, it does have a lot of mechanical features that certainly help the pilot out. Some of its redundant features, as Paul was talking about, you know, these things come back shot up, holes in the wings, sometimes wings missing. When you get down to some of those redundant systems, certainly it's a lot more difficult to fly, more arm flying, talking to guys who have brought that thing back. But like Paul was saying, real tight turn radius, even in an air-to-air environment, fighting these guys over in South Korea, as I'm sure Paul has done several times. It is a formidable foe, even for an F-15 or F-16. They lay on that bat turn right there. They may lose all their speed doing it, but it's tough to hang with those low speeds and tight turns.
Yeah, we're in the 107th Fighter Squadron from Southbridge Air Force Base in Michigan. Pilot Major Peta Nordland from Detroit, Michigan is flying, and Pilot Captain Rucky Charborg from Chatham, Michigan.
We appreciate them taking part. Got some Michigan boys taking part in Thunder over Louisville this year. And you know what? You talk about the pilots. It's nice for you all to come back home, isn't it, to kind of show your wares and what you do for a living.
Oh, yes. It's definitely nice to be able to come back into town. I don't get to come back very often, but, you know, just to come back and have an opportunity to attend a fantastic air show like this, and then the fireworks display is beyond any other that are in the United States.
Something you've got to do once, at least,
absolutely.
Isn't it? It's
absolutely
mind-boggling to see.
I don't think people that actually live here don't have appreciation for how good this is right here in their backyard.
Here's our cockpit cam. We'll check out the old A-10 there and get what the view is like.
Yeah, as you can see right now, the pilot's looking around, picking out his target, setting up for the good passes. Well, all those things are coming in his cross-check, checking his airspeed, his altitude, selecting the proper weapons and airspeed that he's looking for to deliver those weapons. Probably talking on one of the many radios that the A-10 has to the guys and grunts on the ground, asking where they want that ordnance laid down, and probably talking to his wingman as well, trying to get some backup support as he rolls in and get some firepower to help him out. So,
great looking view there, isn't it?
Absolutely. I'll tell you what, I'm jealous. I'd rather be up here than down here right now.